and Lifetime applauds the fight against breast cancer.
I honestly love you. Marge would have loved the fact that we're doing this.
Women get breasts. I mean, you don't order them. Well, some women do.
This year, federal research funding has surpassed the $500 million level for the first time ever.
It's been almost 11 years, and all I have left to remind me of my breast cancer is a little scar on my right breast.
Making love to a woman is like buying real estate. Location, location, location.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, your host for the evening, Olivia Newton-John.
Thank you so much. It really is wonderful to be here tonight. In fact, it's wonderful to be anywhere tonight. And it's especially great to be hosting the second annual Lifetime Applauds the Fight Against Breast Cancer. I feel very lucky to be a survivor of this year's 4 years and going strong. We've got a great show for you tonight. Some of your favorite film, television, and music stars are here to make you laugh, think, clap your hands, and stomp your feet, so stay with us. This is definitely going to be a night to remember. A little over 4 years ago, my father died of cancer on the very same day that I was diagnosed. Believe me, that was a real double whammy. This song is for him.
Decide your destiny. Oh,
Why me or why not me? There is no answer. But there's no question that the issue of breast cancer is now a priority. And that's why so many great performers are here tonight. In the next 2 hours, we'll put you through a full range of emotions, from laughter to tears, with great music thrown in. We're here to entertain, raise awareness, and raise our voices to win this fight. I won the fight, and I've never felt stronger physically and spiritually in my life. Oh, thank you. In 1992, I was celebrating the release of my third greatest hits album and about to start my first major tour in 12 years when I found out that I had breast cancer. It was certainly a wake-up call. I'm a survivor, but I know that not everyone is as lucky as I am, and that's why we must find a way to prevent breast cancer now. I want to be able to look into my daughter's eyes and tell her that she needn't fear this disease in her lifetime. Many women attribute their survival to surgery, chemotherapy, and radiation. I used a mixture of both new science and ancient medicine, and with the help of my doctors, I combined homeopathy, meditation, prayer, yoga, and diet with a very positive mental attitude. That was my path to healing, but each person finds their own to follow. Recently, I did a talk show about cancer, and I was asked if I felt any less of a woman having a breast removed. Pretty tactful, huh? What I'd like to say to everyone that thinks about asking that question is, to lose a breast doesn't make one any less of a woman. It is our spirit and our soul that defines us as women. And it's the spirit and soul of everyone who's ever been touched by breast cancer that's going to change the consciousness of the world and help us heal Mother Nature and, in turn, heal ourselves. There's one more point I'd like to make, and you'll hear this more than once tonight. In life, especially a life that includes cancer, humor is essential. And that's where our first guest comes in. Please welcome a two-time winner of the American Comedy Award for Best Female Stand-Up Comic of the Year, Wendy Liebman. Tonight is a celebration of women, who we are as individuals, and who we are for each other. But our next performer is here to help celebrate us from a man's point of view. And God knows we appreciate being celebrated by men. Especially one with such a memorable and, dare I say, sexy voice. Here with his delicious Oscar-nominated song is Bryan Adams. There's a song that I've been associated with for, dare I say, 25 years that I'd like to do a little bit of right now with these guys. They're going to do it with me. And this is for all of you here and out there whose lives have been touched by this disease. This is from me to you. But I got something to tell you that I never thought I would. But I believe you really ought to know. I love you. I honestly love you. You don't have to answer. I see in your eyes. Maybe it was better left unsaid.
This is pure example, and you must realize that it's coming from my heart, not my head.
I love you, I honestly love you, I honestly love you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the...
This has been a really wonderful experience. I want to thank all of the talented and generous ladies and gentlemen who graced the stage tonight. We're all in this together, and we're richer for your support. I also want to thank everyone in our audience tonight, and all of you watching at home, for staying with us and taking on the fight against breast cancer as your fight. With your voices, your hands, and your hearts on the line, we will win, and we'll find a way to prevent this disease. But one thing is for sure, we're not going to give in to it.
No me voy a rendir, no, no, no me voy a rendir, no, no, no me voy a rendir, no, no, no me voy a rendir. Oh, I'm not gonna give in to it, no. I'm not gonna give in to it, no, no. I'm not gonna give in to it, no. I'm not gonna give in to it. There are times where the moon shines in my eyes and haunts my mind and I can't sleep away.
Thanks to the support of our sponsors and our local affiliates across the country.